So guys, your next comic coming to stage told me to say this verbatim. He is my best friend. Give it up for Diego Rangel.
Give it up for Paolo Sparrow one more time. Yes, my best friend. It's my best friend. Give it up for your wait staff too. They're doing great on that. Tip them well. Tip them well. Yeah, this means a lot to me, you guys being here tonight, because I've been sad a lot lately. You know? Thank you for laughing at that. Well, you know, I found one thing that helps me when I'm feeling down. Is I like to just go out to my car, get in, put my seatbelt on, and just sit there, you know? It just feels nice being held by something that cares about your safety. If I'm feeling really bad, I unbuckle and start driving. Yeah, I drove the Taco Bell today. During the daytime. So seatbelt was off, obviously. And I was ordering some burritos and a lemonade. And when I went to pay at the window, I handed the guy my card and our hands touched. Yeah, it didn't have to be weird, but it was. And, when he handed me my drink, it was a pink lemonade. I was like, well, is this guy flirting with me? At least that's all he could think while sucking his dick. Ever do that? Yeah, he came in my mouth. I was like, excuse me, sir, I didn't order a Baja Blast. It's a twist. A cinnamon twist. Asked for some fire sauce, he just gave me chlamydia. Different kind of burn. I'm glad you guys like the Taco Bell puns. Told that joke yesterday, it didn't land at all, it was dead silent. I was like, it's more of a Taco Bueno audience. New Year's just passed, we got Valentine's Day coming up. Yeah. What's your name, sir? Casey? Jason. Oh, I'm Diego, nice to meet you. Yeah, what's your favorite holiday, Casey? Jason, what? What's your favorite holiday? Let's move on. What's your name, sir? Kim? Gabe? Oh my God, man. What's your favorite holiday, Gabe? Thanksgiving, that's a fun one, it's a family holiday. You know what mine is? Martin Luther King Day, you fucking racist. Jesus Christ, you guys hear Gabe? Says he hates Martin Luther King, man. Jesus Christ. I'm just messing with you, Gabe. It's Christmas. My favorite holiday is Christmas. You're a good sport, I'll get you a drink. Can we get Gabe a water with no ice, please? He's Jewish. God damn. He's Jewish. Are tattoos even worth it if you're black? I'm not trying to make it a racial thing, I'm just saying, you know? It's less contrast. It's all yin and no yang, you feel me? I'm just saying, I don't think it's fair that white people and black people have to pay the same price for the same tattoo when black people only get 3/5 the value, you know what I'm saying? That joke makes some people uncomfortable, but trust me, I was very careful when I wrote it, okay? Yeah. I'm trying online dating. I see a lot of couples here. Online dating's tough, you know? But I've learned a lot. I've learned a lot through online dating. Like, I finally learned the difference between astrology and astronomy. Astronomy, if you didn't know, is the study of stars and space. And astrology is an excuse to be a rude bitch. Got a couple Scorpios back there. Yeah, and I'm but most profiles are all pretty much the same, you know? So my bio, I write, I like weird girls. Which, yeah, probably should have thought about before putting that, because my next two matches, both of them went to DDLG. Anyone know what that is? I'm gonna tell you. It's Daddy Dom Little Girl Roleplay. I'm not trying kink shame, but if I'm being honest, I'm really not into that. Mostly because I'm into MDLB, which is Mommy Dom Little Boy Roleplay. Do we have any mommies tonight? Please. Please. There's never any mommies. One of the girls messaged me first, though. And that's pretty rare. She said that she was into more aggressive men. So now I have an idea about how her father treated her. Well, you know, I tell her I'm not aggressive. I'm a good Christian boy. Her response is, okay, D, at least eat ass. Do we have any ass eaters tonight? No, that's disgusting. All right, the only ass I eat is the ass of the bread. You know the ends nobody eats, they just throw away. Which I think people find eating that more disgusting than having the faint taste of shit in their mouth. Yeah, I told her that. That was the last straw. She unmatched with me. But if I'm being honest, I think it's best I worked out that way. Because I think the last thing that she needed was another daddy to leave her. You know, I'm a pretty monogamous guy, you know. Like, I'm not judging if you're polyamorous or anything. I just prefer to be loyal to one person. Someone just laughed at that? Yeah, married guy laugh at that. Yeah, but like I said, I'm not judging if polyamorous. I just prefer to be loyal to one person, you know. Like, I even watch the same porn star every single time. I mean, he's pounding a different girl every video, but that's my guy, you know. Gabe's my guy. Yeah. And you know, like, when I see things like that, not necessarily like the ass eating, but like the fetishes, I see that as like insecurity. And I think one insecurity that a lot of men share, whether they admit it or not, is how long they can last in bed. Looking at you, Gabe. But it shouldn't be like that, man, you know? Because nature isn't like that. Like, hear me out. Wolves, for example. Pack hunting, apex predators. They only last about 20 seconds, which made me feel better, if I'm being honest. You can last twice as long as a wolf. Very impressive, I know, until I did the math. Then I realized that 40 seconds of doggy style is still about 5.5 minutes in dog time, so in the end, they still got me beat. All right, guys. That's gonna about do it for my time. Okay, there we go.